call it thrift business or kirika business or second-hand items business, you are referring to the same business model. In this video, I'll be putting you through on how you can get started. It doesn't matter if you're a beginner or a professional. If you are a returning subscriber, keep being amazing. If you are new here, you are welcome. Please subscribe and hit the notification bell so you don't miss out on any of my videos on online business and personal development. Let's get started. To get started with any business, not just thrift business, the first thing you have to do is to get a business plan. A business plan is like a roadmap. It will guide you in the course of the business. It is in your business plan that you will map out who your customers are, what are their age brackets, what are their income level, where are they located, how do you get to them. You have to map all of this out before starting any business. If you don't know how to get a business plan, I have already made a comprehensive video about that. I'll be linking it in the description box below. Get a business plan and a marketing plan. Do your SWOT analysis before starting out. Once you are done, learn the trade. You have to learn the trade from someone who's already established in the business. The reason is to avoid mistakes. When you are learning, be diligent. Be patient. You will learn a lot. The idea of learning from someone who is already established, who is doing well in the business, is to learn the rules and the tricks. Learning the practical aspect of it is enough, but you have to do more to avoid mistakes. In the course of your learning, you will learn how to attend to customers, learn customer behavior, how to source for your products. It can take months. Be diligent. Be patient. You will learn a lot from those who are already established, so that when you start out, when you meet any challenges, you can handle them. Once you are done learning, the first thing you have to do is to get a business name and register it. If you register your business, find your line of business. Don't just start out and start selling anything at all. You have to concentrate on a particular, maybe for kiddies, for adults, shoes, bags, household items. Identify your line of business. Don't start investing hugely in the business, except you know your client base and patronage. You don't need to start huge immediately. You have to invest a little and be optimistic, be realistic, keep your options open, because definitely there will be ups and downs in the business. When this happens, how do you recollect yourself? How do you move on? Select the one you want to go into. Don't be jack of all trades. You have to concentrate on one. However, you have to get ready for the challenges ahead. If your customers are not really into what you are doing, be ready to adjust to what your clients want. Because believe it or not, it is what the customers want that you'll be selling. You don't sell what you want. All right. Once you've chosen your line of business, the next thing is to get a location. Location in any business is very important. It could be in a mall, in a shopping mall. It could be in the marketplace or in the open. It could be a shop. It could be from your house. Whichever one is suitable for you, get it done right now. This is the time to choose where you will be located, where your customers can find you. You can start from home. If you have the money already, you can rent a shop. Make sure your location is where people can find you. If you are taking your business to social media, start advertising. Which social media platform would you be using? Facebook is okay. Instagram is okay too. You can get influencers to advertise for you, just to showcase your business to your clients. Let people know what you do. You've learned the business from someone who is already established. You've gotten your line of business, a location. It is time to start promoting your business. You can do this through word of mouth, through social media. You can take your business to offices, schools, and hospitals, wherever you think your customers are. Locate them. Put your business in their faces. Let them know what you do and how they can contact you. If you are selling clothes for kids, you can take it to hospitals, to schools. From there, you can get customers. If you are selling goods for adults, you can take it to offices. These are where you can locate these people. Don't just sit in the comfort of your shop or your home and expect people to come to you. No, gone are those days when those things happen. Now, don't wait for your customers to come to you. Go to them. Let them know what you do. Let them know how they can contact you. And if you are selling online, make sure you utilize every available social media platform where your customers are. If you don't have followership, get social influencers to help you. They will charge you, yes, but the token is not just, it's not so much. The next thing is to determine how much you will sell your product. For whatever product you are selling, you have to take into consideration the cost of the bill, the cost of your shop or warehouse or wherever you are operating from, and the cost of transportation. This is very important. You have to put all these things into place before arriving at the final price. If not, you will be running helter-skelter to pay for shop and other miscellaneous things. You don't want that. The money you will be using to service this shop and this business should be coming from this shop. So you have to put all of this into consideration to arrive at your price. Ensure you are keeping record of every item in stock, your profit and your loss, and of course, your income. This will enable you to keep a proper record. You can start this on your own for the meantime. With time, you can employ someone to do it for you. Make sure you don't sell credit. You don't sell credit to your friends and business. Business will always thrive when friends and family pay for the services rendered to them. When you're selling to your friends and your family, make sure you are collecting your money. If not, as time goes on, you will start looking for the money you invested in this business. Again, you can consider buying in consignment. You don't have to pay up front before a bill is given to you. You can buy on consignment, and in the course of selling, you can be remitting this money to whoever supplied it to you. This way, you don't need a huge startup capital to begin with. So in a nutshell, to get started with thrift business, you have to get your business plan and marketing plan ready. Learn the business from someone who is already established. This is to learn the rules and the tricks in the business as well as avoid mistakes. Get a business name and register it. Choose your line of business. Get a very good location. Locate your customers. Promote and advertise your goods. Take into consideration the cost of the bill, cost of transportation, and of course, the shop and other miscellaneous things while arriving at the price of your product. Once you are done, congratulations. If you have any question as regards how to start a thrift business, let me know in the comment section below. Thanks for watching. Hope this video was helpful. Please like, give it a thumbs up, share with whoever you think might need this video, and I will see you in my next one. Cheers to your success. Bye-bye.